Dear students, today I will teach you relation, and this class will be very important in mathematics because the relation functions are very important chapters in mathematics, and I will teach you in such a way that you will become the guru or the master of relation, but also the master of mathematics, the techno guru. How can be a techno guru in mathematics? So this is the important class. Let's doubt disappears after single watch. I will promise you, after watching single times this video, you can teach others relation. Many times students are confused what is relation, but the students, relation is simply another form of a set. See, simply it is another form of a set, means this is nothing but a set. How relation is a set? Let A is equal to ABC, B is equal to 1, 2, 3, A cross B is equal to, as we know in my previous class, I have already described, A cross B is equal to A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. This is the product set. This A cross B is product set. So dear students, every set has some subsets. Every set has some subsets. So if A cross B is a set, then A cross B, this set, must have some subsets. Dear students, Cartesian product set has also some subsets. Okay, again I am saying, relation is nothing but another form of a set, means relation itself is a set. So which sets are relation? What is the definition of relation? Look at here. Yeah. Let A and B be two non-empty sets. So we have given two sets, A and B, which are non-empty. That means they are not void sets. So the relation, suppose R is the name of relation. The relation R from A to B. A relation is always moving from one set to another set. It is directional. It has a direction from one set to another set. So here R is the relation which is from A to B. So if R is a relation, then what is a relation? Now it is defined as, the relation is defined as a subset of A cross B. So a relation means the subset of A cross B. You know A cross B, the product set, is a set, and every set has some subsets. So the relation R is a subset of A cross B. If R is a subset of A cross B, then R is a set. Any subset is also a set. So if R is a subset of A cross B, then R itself is a set. So I have already said, relation is nothing but a set. So which set is relation? So any subset of A cross B. So if you take any subset of A cross B, if A cross B is a set, it has many subsets. So any subset of A cross B is a relation from A to B. So that set will be relation from A to B, which is the subset of A cross B. So relation means subset of the Cartesian product. Any subset of a Cartesian product, any subset of A cross B, is a relation from A to B. Let us take an example. So here A cross B is this one. Now I take a set R as A1, B2. Look at here. R is a set consisting of two elements, A1, B2. So dear students, A1, B2, these two elements are present in A cross B. Look at here, A1 and B2. If these two elements are present here, that means R is a subset of A cross B. So R is a subset of A cross B, but the definition of a relation is any subset of a Cartesian product is a relation. So here R is the subset of a Cartesian product. That means R is relation from A to B. So relation means subset of Cartesian product. Relation is nothing but the another form of a set. It is set. So which set can be relation? The set which is a subset of a Cartesian product A cross B, that will be the relation from A to B. If R is a relation, then R is subset of A cross B. If R is subset of A cross B, then R is a relation from A to B. So, dear students, if R is a relation, so R is a set. If R is a set, then there must be some elements. Look at here, the examples. The elements of a relation are A1, B2. So, similarly, you can take lots of examples. How? So, another example is, if we take R is equal to A1, A2, A3. Look at here, these three elements are present here. That means R is a subset of A cross B. So, I can write R is relation from A to B. So, any subset of A cross B is a relation. Cartesian product ka koi bhi subset le lo, wo relation ho jayega from A to B. If R is a relation, then R is subset of A cross B means R is a set. If R is a set, then how can we write it? Here R is A1, B2. That means here R is written in tabular method or list method. But in generally, we can write the set R as, look at here, if R is a subset of A cross B, but the elements of A cross B always exists in order pair form. R is a subset of A cross B. All elements of R are present in A cross B, but all the elements of A cross B are always in form of Cartesian or always in form of ordered pairs. So the elements of the relation R is also exists in ordered pair form. That means we can write the set R as X, Y such that all the elements of R in ordered pair form. That means X, Y form. Here the first element X, that means here, look at here, A, B are in first set and the second components are in second set. So the elements of R exist in form of XY. That means the set R is equal to XY, where the first component X belongs to A and the second component Y belongs to B. So if R is a relation from A to B, then we can write R is equal to XY such that X belongs to A and Y belongs to B. Relation is always from one set to another set. Take an example. Suppose a girl of one family married to a boy of another family. Then there is a relation created between two families. That means the relation is from one family to another family. Relation moves from family to family. But practically what happens? Who are related among themselves? The family, this family and that family are related. Means actually relation exists between the members of the family. The members of this family are related with the members of other family. That means the relation moves from one family to other family, but practically the members are related. Practically the members are related. Similarly, here the relation is, I have already said, relation is directional. It moves from one set to another set, but practically the elements are related. Relation is from one set to another set, but there is a relation between the elements of two sets. So here A is the set A, B, C, B is the set 1, 2, 3. Relation is from here, R is relation here, R is relation from A to B. But practically, the elements of A set and B set are related. But which element has what type of relation with the other elements? This is important thing. Look at here. Here is A, B, C. Here is 1, 2, 3. But the R, the relation consists of two elements, A1, B2. Means A has a relation with 1, B has a relation with 2. A has a relation with 1, B has a relation with 2. In this relation, A has no relation with 3. B has no relation with 1. So, when there is a relation between two families, every type of relation does not exist with every members. There may be brotherhood. That means, if A is brother of B, that means A is always boy. A can't be girl. So, the members are related, but particular relation exists among some particular members. Like here, A has relation with 1, but A is not related with 2, A is not related with 3. So how can we find which element of set A is related with which element of set B? Look at here. This order pair can say which elements are related with which elements. But there are two types of order pairs. Some order pairs are here in the product set, but some order pairs are here in the relation set. But the students, very important thing is the order pair which is present in the relation set can say which elements are related with which elements. Look at here. Here is A1. That means A is related with 1. But here is C2. But C is not related with 2. So the elements of a relation set can able to say which elements are related with which elements. How an order pair XY belongs to R, then we can say X is related with Y. If the order pair belongs to R, then X is related to Y. That means A1 belongs to R. This order pair belongs to R means A has a relation with 1. B2, the order pair belongs to R, B has a relation with 2. But if XY does not belong to R, then X is not related with Y. Look at here. If we take this relation, an element B3 is present in the product set, but this is not present in R. That means B is not related with 3. So, which element is related with which element can be found from the order pairs present in the relation set. One very important thing, the number of relations. If you have given the number of elements of two sets A and B, then how can you find the number of relations from A to B? So here, let A has M elements, B has N elements. Then the Cartesian product set A cross B has M into N number of elements you have already discussed. So if A cross B has M into N number of elements, then the power set of A cross B has 2 to the power M into N number of elements. So, dear students, we want to find number of relations from A to B. Here, the number of elements of A and B are given. So, number of relations from A to B. Dear students, R can be relation from A to B if R is a subset of A cross B. Any subset of A cross B is a relation. If any subset of A cross B is a relation, then how many relations are possible? The number of relations will be the number of subsets. The number of relations will be the number of relations is same as the number of subsets, because if R is a subset, then R is a relation. In order to be R a relation, then R should be the subset. So, as every subset is a relation, then the number of relations means the number of subsets. So, the number of relations from A to B is equal to number of subsets of A cross B. And the number of subsets of A cross B, we know the number of subsets of a set is the number of elements in its power set, because power set is the set of all subsets. So the number of subsets of A cross B means the number of elements present in its power set. So the number of elements present in the power set of A cross B is 2 to the power mn and is equal to 2 to the power mn. So if A has m elements, B has n elements, then the number of relations from A to B is equal to 2 to the power mn. Three very important parts of a relation. These are domain, range and codomain. Suppose R be a relation from A to B. That is, R is subset of A cross B. If R is a relation, then we can write it as XY such that X belongs to A, Y belongs to B. We know that every element of a relation always exists in the form of order pairs. That means two components, first component, second component. X is the first component, Y is the second component. So it's clear relation is a set, but the elements of a relation exist in all form of order pairs. So, dear students, if I want to form a set consisting of only first components, consisting of only X of a relation, that will be set. If I want to form another set which consists of the second components of the relation, that means here R set is in form of XY. I want to form a set consisting of only X, that is, look at here, this set is known as domain set of a relation. How? Domain, the set of all first components x such that xy belongs to R is domain of R. That means it is denoted by domain of R such that is equal to. So domain of R means the set of all first components. That means the set of only x. We have to form a set taking only x out of this order pair. From these order pairs, take only x, form a set that will be domain set. So it is denoted by domain of R, which is equal to x such that. Look at here, x such that means it is not xy such that. That means the set domain set consisting of only x, the first components. So the set of x only of such that, the set of x only such that xy belongs to R. That means you have to form a set of only first components and range the set of second components of y. Here the second component is y, so you have to form a set consisting of the second components only, that means y only, where xy belongs to R, is known as range of R. So range of R is denoted by range R, which is the set y such that xy belongs to R. That means you have to take y from the order pairs of the relation. Now is the codomain. Codomain means if R is a relation from A to B, then the set B is known as a codomain set. So in case of relation, codomain is a B set. That means entire set is codomain, but range is some part or all, some or all elements of B. That the relation is a range is a subset of a codomain. I take one important example here. A is a set 2, 3, 4, B is a set 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, A has 3 elements and B has 5 elements. So, the number of elements in A cross B is 5 and 3 is 15. So, and the power set of A cross B has 2 to the power 15 number of elements. That means the number of a subset of, I have already said, the number of subsets of a set is the number of elements in its power sets. That means A cross B has 2 to the power 15 number of subsets. And the number of relations from A to B, as we know, the number of relations from A to B is 2 to the power m into n means 2 to the power 15. Now, here I have defined a relation xy, R is equal to xy such that x is a divisor of y. Look at here, the elements of R exist in form of order pairs. So x is related with y. The elements will be in form of x, y, where the first element should be divisor of second element. X is divisor of y means the first element should be divisor of second element. And we have to choose x from A set and y from B set. Let us take x 2. So 2 is here, and here will be the number whose divisor is 2. 2 is not a divisor of 5. So here 5 cannot be written. But 2 is divisor of 6. So 2 has a relation with 6. 2 is not divisor of 7, 2 is divisor of 8, so 2 is divisor of 8, x is divisor of y, so 2 is divisor of 8, 2 is not divisor of 9, then comes to second x means 3. Now if I take 3 here, 3 is divisor of 6 and 9, so 3 is 6, 3 9, then I take 5, 4, and 4 is divisor of only 8, so 4 8. So this is the set, this is the relation. So here R is in form of set builder form, and here R is in list method. So now look at here, I want to find domain. Look at here, all the elements of a relation are in order pair form, but the domain is the set of first components only. That means the domain of this relation is 2, 2, 3, 3, 4. That means 2, 3, 4. And range of R is the set of second elements 6, 8, 6, 9, 8. That means 6, 8, 9. So look at here. And which is codomain? Codomain is B set. Codomain is B set, which implies, look at here, this is the range set, and this is codomain, which implies range R is a subset of a codomain. Now is inverse relation. Look at here, inverse of a relation. If R is a relation from A to B, then the relation from B to A is known as inverse relation. If R is a relation from A to B, then the relation from B to A is the inverse of R. And if R is a relation from A to B, then R is a subset of A cross B, which implies R inverse is a relation from B to A. That means R inverse is a subset of B cross A. And R inverse can be written as, look at here, we are writing R as XY, but R inverse as YX, such that X belongs to A and Y belongs to B. So this is the inverse relation of R. Thing is, the cardinality of A cross B is same as cardinality of B cross A. That means the number of relations from A to B is same as the number of relations from B to A. So number of relations from A to B is equal to number of relations from B to A. Remind, number of A, the cardinality of A cross B is equal to cardinality of B cross A. So number of relations from A to B is same as number of relations from B to A. Verse. Here is R given. A is given 2, 3, 4. B is given 5, 6, 7, 8. R is the set 2, 6, 2, 8, 3, 6, 3, 9, 4, 8. And from this we have R inverse. We know R is in form of XY and R inverse is from B to A, that means in form of YX. That means if R is this set, the inverse of this is 6, 2, YX. YX means 8, 2. Then is 6, 3, 9, 3, and the last one is 8, 4. So if R is this set, then the inverse of R inverse is this one. Now is what is the set? What is the domain of R? So what is the domain of R inverse? And we know if R inverse is a relation, it also has a domain and range, but the domain of R inverse, domain means the set of X components, the set of first elements means 6, 8, 6, 8, 9. And range of R means the set of second elements means 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. Look at here. Here, domain of R inverse is 6, 8, 9, which is the range of R. So, we find domain of R inverse is range of R. Range of R is domain of R. So, we have domain of R is range. Domain of R is range of R inverse, and range of R is domain of R inverse. Diagrammatic representation. Look at here. A consists of the elements 2, 3, 4. B consists of 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And from the relation A, R is a relation from A to R is a relation from A to B. And in this relation, we have 2 is related to 6. 2 is related to 6. So put an arrow. 2 is related to 8 also, 2 is related to 8, and 3 is related to 6, and 3 is related to 9, 4 is related to 8. So this is the diagrammatic representation. Always the relation moves from one set to another set, but the relation is actually, but actually the elements are related, and this arrow mark represents the relation between the elements. Another set. Now is relation on a set. Let R is a subset of A cross A. If R is a subset of A cross A, that means R is the subset of this Cartesian product, then R is a relation. So here is R is a relation from A to A, and which is known as R is a relation on A. So when a relation is from a set to itself, that is known as the relation on a set. Next, discuss trivial relation. So there are two relations which are known as trivial relation. These are empty or void relation. Another is inversal relation. Void relation means we know that phi set is subset of every set. So phi is also subset of A cross A, and this is Cartesian product. As phi is subset of Cartesian product, and every subset of Cartesian product is a relation. So phi is also a relation from A to A. But phi is a relation from A to A means phi is a relation on A. So phi is a relation on A. So this phi is known as, this relation is known as a void relation or empty relation. Means here what happens, no element of A is related with any element of A. No element of A is related with any element of A. That means phi set is empty set. That means this relation has no elements. The next is the universal relation. We know every set is a subset of itself. So A cross A is also subset of A cross A. As A cross A is a subset of Cartesian product, then A cross A is also relation from A to A. That means A cross A is a relation on A. And this A cross A is known as the universal relation. That means this A cross A means which consists of all elements of the Cartesian product. Here, this is the smallest relation and this is the largest relation. These two, the smallest and largest relations, are known as the trivial relations. One is phi, the void, where the relation has no elements. It's empty set. No element of A is related with any element of A. Here, all elements of A are related with every element of A. No element of A, A ka koi bhi element, A का कोई भी एलिमेंट का रिलेशन A का किसी भी एलिमेंट के साथ नहीं होगा. हियर A का एवरी एलिमेंट का रिलेशन A का एवरी एलिमेंट्स के साथ रिलेशन रहेगा. सो दिस इज द स्मॉलेस्ट रिलेशन, दिस इज द लार्जेस्ट रिलेशन. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ नो एलिमेंट्स, इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ ऑल एलिमेंट्स. एग्जांपल A इज 2 4 6 8. R इज अ रिलेशन x y such that x plus y is equal to R. दैट मीन्स x बिलोंग्स टू A, हियर x y बिलोंग्स टू A. सो x इज 2 4 6 8, y इज ऑल्सो 2 4 6 8, बट वी हैव टू फाइंड टू नंबर्स हुज सम इज ऑड नंबर. बट लुक एट हियर 2 4 6 8, दैट फोर नंबर्स आर इवन नंबर्स. द सम ऑफ एनी टू कैन नॉट बी ऑड. सो वी कैंट फाइंड एनी x y वेयर द सम इज ऑड. सो हियर x plus y is not equal to or for all x y. So if x y is not equal to or, that means when x y is equal to or, then x y belongs to R. If x y is not equal to or, that means x y does not belongs to R. If x y doesn't belongs to R, that means R is empty. R is empty. So this R is empty. So R is empty. That means this is empty relation. Another example, A is 2 4 6 8. R is a relation x y such that x plus y is even. That means here x is belongs to A, y belongs to A, and x is 2 4 6 8, y is also 2 4 6 8. We have to find two numbers whose sum is even, but here all the numbers are even. If we take any two numbers, then the sum must be even. That means here x plus y is equal to even for all x y belongs to A. That which implies each element of A is related with every element of A. R is equal to A cross A. If R is equal to A cross A, that means this is universal relation. Another important relation is the identity relation. So let A be any set, then the relation IA, the identity relation is given by IA, which is AA such that A belongs to A. This is known as identity relation. In identity relation, A has a relation with A. That means every element is related with itself. This relation is identity relation. A is a set 2, 4, 6. R is a relation x y such that x minus y is equal to 0 for all x y belongs to R. That means we have to find x y from A where the difference is 0. Look at here, if x is 2, then y should be 2. That means 2 minus 2 is 0. If x is 4, y is also 4, 4 minus 4 is 0, 6 minus 6 is 0. So here 2, 2, 4, 4, 2 is related with 2, 4 is with 4, 6 with 6. That means every element has relation with itself. So this is identity relation. Thanks.